Let's say someone asks how to create a new model in Ollama. I can answer that question pretty easily, but I actually have a video that talks about it somewhere. It would be better if I could just send them in the right direction. Then the other person wins by seeing a full explanation of the problem. I win because I get another view for a video or two. The problem is that I don't always know which video I covered that topic in. So I wanted a simple way to run a search and get a list of videos that can point the user in the right direction. It's kind of like RAG, but a little different. I'm not using the information to generate an answer, but rather just using Ollama to create embeddings that I'll use to find the right video for the person to watch. I created a simple app that would achieve this, and I plan on using that app as a base for a series of videos I'll be doing. Because in building the app, I had to make a bunch of decisions, each of which is interesting on its own and sometimes not the best decision, so we can see what the other options are later on. For instance, we could talk about how to store the embedding, how to search for those embeddings, how to chunk up some text to perform the embedding, and what are the embeddings in the first place. At a high level, I'm pulling all my transcripts from my videos from YouTube, then processing them to create text of a certain length. Then I generate embeddings for those bits of text and store them somewhere. Then I do a comparison to find the most similar text to whatever question I have. Then I output the answer in a way that makes sense for this solution. I'm going to make all the code for this series available on my GitHub account, which is github.com/technoevangelist. The actual repo is called, creatively, Video Projects. And while I tend to do things in TypeScript first because it's just easier for me, I'll try to also have it in the repo in Python for those of you who prefer that for whatever reason. Another note, I am not a professional software developer, though I have done that in my past. Often my code will get the job done, but it's not the best way to do things. Like, you'll rarely find any tests, and I often assume the input's good, so there's minimal error checking. In fact, I just posted a tweet asking if there's a more appropriate license that I can slap on it. So let's start looking at the code to see what's going on. I'm going to skip the part about downloading the transcripts because it has nothing to do with the embeddings, and I'm pretty sure the method I have chosen would perturb some folks. The source transcripts are in a special XML format that YouTube uses called TTML. YouTube also has SRT and other subtitle formats, but it isn't used consistently on all videos. And the TTML format is. So my embed script is going to use the glob library to make it easier to select all the files in a directory, a fast XML parser, and also Ollama. First, I define a type that I'm going to use for my transcript chunks. Then I iterate through all the subtitles in the captions directory. I want to store the video ID and title in the metadata for each embed, so I parse that out with a regex. Then I read in each file and just do some quick cleanup of the incoming text. Next, I parse through the XML in this parseXML function. So parseXML takes the XML string and the ID and title of the video. The XML parser library simply converts the XML to JSON, which is easier to work with. Here's an example of the raw XML, and you can see that the good stuff shows up under the body tag, then div, then p. So for each p tag, grab the text and the beginning timestamp, then push that to an array, and that's the return from the function. Each of the items in this array are pretty short text snippets, depending on the file. So there are actually two different types of TTML files in what I got from YouTube. The en-us files are subtitles based on the script I gave YouTube, because every video like this is actually fully scripted, and I'm just reading from a teleprompter. Some folks have asked how I'm able to keep these so concise. Well, that is how. Without a script and a teleprompter, I'd be all over the place with so many So the subtitle files from those videos have punctuation. The EN files are text that's generated by YouTube. They're probably just live streams or videos that I was lazy with. They tend to skip punctuation. But in both cases, the text is a bit short. So think about that. If I want to find out when I describe a short concept, maybe I want the snippets as they are. But usually the concepts take a bit more to describe. If I search for that, nothing will come up as matching. So determining the size of your chunks of text depends on the types of questions you're going to ask. Then think about where a concept is described in that text. what are the chances that the concept will be covered within 10 of those snippets? Is there a chance that it will start in one group and then continue in the next? If so, a match won't ever be made. So we need to overlap a bit too. So that's what the next function does. I'm grouping the first number of snippets together, then moving forward that number minus the overlap of snippets, and then grouping another group of that first number. This is another decision that should be looked at a bit more. Is that the right amount of overlap? The more overlap you have with the smaller chunk size, the bigger the data store gets, and maybe the more bad matches you might get. I'll probably do a video just looking at this a bit more. Each of those groups I'm referring to as a chunk. Once I have my chunks, I generate embeddings from them, and then push all of them across all files to a single JSON file. And for this first video, that's my vector database, or more accurately, a vector store. It's just text in a JSON file. Is that the best way to store this? I don't think so, but it's a place to start from. In future videos, I want to look at some options for vector databases and see what they can offer and how they can make things better. I've run this on a set of videos that I have done in the last few weeks. I think if you include streams and shorts, I average about a video every day and a quarter. So just those videos comes out to about 22 megabytes if my chunks are 10 long with an overlap of 5. So now that we have all the embeds in our data store, let's search for text. I'm just using Ollama in this and a library called Compute Cosine Similarity. This is the algorithm most vector databases will actually use to find how similar two embeddings are. What it basically does is take two floating point numbers, and if you were to draw a line from them to zero, what would the angle be between them? I think. Anyway, the smaller the number, the more similar the embedding. And there are other algorithms some databases use. Again, another video. I define a new type for the JSON that I want to work with and then read in my embedding store. Then read in the question from the command line and embed that. Now for each embedding, I determine the similarity and store that in an array. I don't just want the best matches, but also want to see how often any one video has matches. Then finally, I output the matches and I can quickly copy and paste a result into the Discord conversation. And hopefully if another few thousand folks watch a video, I get a dollar. I'll try searching for some concepts, maybe install on Windows, and we see some results. Add a model, and here are some more. It'd be nice to summarize the results of each mention to see why watching any one video would be interesting for the search concept. And that's all stuff that we can look at in future videos. So that's it for this one. Let me know what you think. Have you done anything similar? Let me know in the comments below. And if you have any questions, let me know about those as well, or even ideas for future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Bye. I have no water. Getting a little parched.